Or good evening, Mr. Halad, and thanks for taking our call.
Good evening, Stanley. Good evening to all our viewers.
Yes, I know that the President has made the rounds of the affected areas in Batanes. What has so far been discussed?
Well, there are so many things that we discussed, and specifically, there were two instructions that involved myself as the administrator of OCD and the executive director of NDRMC. There are other instructions that involve specific agencies. And for my part, he mentioned improvement of our communication systems, not relying so much on the telcos that we can use during emergency situations. And we are actually partly compliant to that already because we have a project being implemented by the ICT, what we call the Government Emergency Communication System, and I recommended that for its expansion, we should require the local government units to procure high-frequency audio, and for that also to be adopted widely among national government agencies. Another instruction that he gave to me is ensuring the continuity of supply of relief goods, and I assure the President that we will be doing several sorties in the next few days, in addition to the two sorties of C-130 that we were able to accomplish today.
All right. Are there any other developments in the rescue operations that you have started since yesterday?
Well, the governor issued a hold on the retrieval or rescue of one missing person. Person who ran to a cave, and unfortunately that cave collapsed. That's the only one person that is declared missing now. And so the casualties runs at 8 dead and 63 injured, and plus that one missing. And we are still assessing the extent of damage to properties, houses, government facilities and infrastructures. But initially, BPWH came up with an estimate, an initial estimate of about 17 million.
All right. Although the President has promised some funding, it is essential that the provincial government has access also to additional funds, of course, for relief and rehabilitation. Are there any plans to declare a state of calamity in Batanes?
Well, actually, I suggested that the local government should look at declaring a state of calamity, but offhand I can see that it will be only probably the municipality of Itbayat that will satisfy the parameters that we issued. And but anyway, with that, I think the provincial government of Batanes can tap on their existing resources, the local calamity fund, in order to augment the resources of the municipality of Itbayat. And then with that municipality's declaration of state of calamity also, that will provide them access to any financial assistance from the national government.
All right. On that note, thanks a lot for taking our call, Mr. Ricardo Halad, Executive Director of the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council. Thank you.